Well, Oakland is certainly shining in the spotlight these days with a growing list of films produced by local directors and all set right here in the town. Among them, Sorry to Bother You. That's the debut film from director Boots Riley. And coming up this weekend, Riley is going to join other local directors and artists in Oakland to showcase their films. And joining us now is the curator of this upcoming film series happening tomorrow here in Oakland, Cheryl Fabio.
Thank you. Thank you.
I really appreciate you coming in. I appreciate it. So you got Boots Riley's going to be there tomorrow and a number of other directors as well. What is the focus of this film series?
Well, we got a grant from Akinade Foundation, a local funder, to take a look at the black arts movement from the 60s and the 70s. And my decision was to look at that movement as a foundation for some of what you're seeing today. You know, I was at the Black Panther and I said, you know, there's a history to this, and I don't know if people realize that his political statements that are embedded in Black Panther come from a very Oakland tradition of, and this is the title of the series, kind of resistance or resilience and an anticipation of the future. So our program has gone all the way back. We've got, we started March the 1st. There have been panels that were artists. There were panels, there was a folk artist that was part of it. We've got actually Carol Lawrence and Avon Kirkland, who are Bay Area filmmakers. So we're just really throwing at all of that work to show the tradition of how black arts in Oakland have been.
Well, it certainly does seem like it, right now Oakland is having a Hollywood moment, I guess you could say. I mean, you talked about Black Panther, other films, Sorry to Bother You, Blind Spotting as well, Fruitvale Station not long ago, all these films showcasing the city. Well, why do you think right now the spotlight has shifted to Oakland all of a sudden?
Well, you know, part of it is that a lot of this filmmaking started with independent film. Mm-hmm. And so Fruitvale Station, Sorry to Bother You, started as an independent film. And so you've got and the talent is so strong that what are you going to do with someone who made something as potent as Fruitvale Station? When I leave the country, people talk about that film. So, you know, it leads to opportunities, and this is a moment, I think, where there's so much cultural shifting going on that a place like Oakland that has a strong tradition of making meaningful films, it's just the right moment for it.
Why do you think why is it so important for people who live in Oakland to see their city represented on the big screen in these
You know,
films?
Because it explains so much, and I mentioned to you that I had made a film about West Oakland. And there's something about getting your history fed to you that tells you, it reflects back who you are, where you're going, where you want to be going, and all of that. So it's part of us seeing our identity and kind of learning where to put our foot next, you know, in the next step. It's also about a civil society in some ways.
And I know you said to me before we came on that there, you know, people here in Oakland, filmmakers in particular, have been doing a lot of great work for a very long time.
Absolutely.
But it seems as though that moving into the mainstream, that's only happened more recently. Well, why did it take so long, you think?
Well, first of all, the Bay Area is known for independent film, for documentary film. It's known for, and there's filmmaking has changed just incredibly over the past 20 years, so that talent that is local, you know, everything was in LA before.
Sure.
That local talent has access to the world instantly because of now how we make films.
Are we going to start seeing a lot more movies shot on location in Oakland?
Why not? It's an amazing...
Fine with me.
You know, it's an amazing urban environment that has Well, that is if we keep it that way. Now, if you push out the people who have been a talent base here, who knows what's going to happen? And in fact, as Oakland changes, who knows what it's going to look like in another 10 years? But the mix of what African Americans have brought to the culture of Oakland, it's priceless because we're kind of small and we influence, but it's a very rich culture of artistic endeavor.
It certainly is. I want to make sure we get the information out there about the film series happening tomorrow. Tell me where it's happening and tell me the information that people need to know. I know it's free for everyone.
It's free, 81st Avenue Library, which is exciting itself.
Okay.
That's a public space that we're using. We're trying to maximize use of it.
Sure.
It's a lovely facility. So 81st Avenue Library in East Oakland.
Okay, great.
Also, New Parkway Theater, my film, Evolutionary Blues, on Tuesday night.
Okay, wonderful. Thank you very much,
Cheryl
Fabian.
So
thanks for coming in. Appreciate
Thank
it.
You.